The second key area is the physical layer. So there are broadly three mechanisms here. So remember again, you have a particular channel, RF layer tried to clean out the channel, physical layer is now going to try to glean as many bits as possible out of a given channel. That's its job. So the first thing is, with 802.11abg, you had approximately 20 megahertz for every channel. Okay, so this is just the spectrum width, and this is the amount of the bandwidth, the RF bandwidth that could be used in order to pump bits through the channel. As you would think of in terms of traffic lanes, if you double the number of lanes, you're going to be able to pump or speed up the traffic, right? The same concept applies. So think of 20 megahertz as effectively being two lanes worth of traffic. What 802.11n does is, in addition to the 20 megahertz, it gives you the option of setting 40 megahertz channels. So in other words, it widens the road from two lanes to four lanes. That allows a lot more traffic to go through, and hence increases the capacity of the network. So the first point is, getting from 20 to 40, just by blind math, allows you to double the capacity. The second thing it does is, it allows for a better encoding, what's known as 64-QAM encoding. So it allows for a better encoding of bits to hertz. And this is really a very subtle point, hard to explain without getting into sort of deep math. But the point is, for a given hertz, in other words, for a given amount of spectrum, this encoding scheme allows you to pack more and more bits in. Now, there is a trade-off between packing more information and making information more lossy. So all these RF layer mechanisms try to make sure that the signal is clean enough so that the signal is less lossy. And the PHY, relying on that, says, I'm now going to start pumping more and more information. At a very high-level analogy, think of it as, I have a given amount of time to communicate to you, and I can either speak slow, in which case, even if you lose some words, more or less, or even if you lose some time, more or less you'll get the flow of what I say. But the information that I communicate is limited. Or I speak really fast and communicate a lot of information. In which case, if you lose even a few seconds, you might actually lose information. But assuming that you get the entire communication, I'm able to pack a lot more information into you. So this concept of more bits per hertz is just the equivalent of speaking much faster in a given amount of time. And 802.11n is able to do that very effectively. There is a third thing, which is a mixed mode preamble. I'm going to skip that because, again, it is more a way, it's a more of mechanics than core technology. And what I want to do in this talk is focus more on sort of the core technology aspects that cause 11n to deliver the performance that it does. So let's step back in terms of the physical layer. There's wider channels, broadened the freeway. There's more bits per hertz, talk faster. And there's mixed mode preamble, which again is a way of wasting less amount of bandwidth and airtime.